to start it off. Maybe just testing the waters there, see how confident her opponent is right away on the receive. No doubt she'll be very much so.
Good exchange here, Sun Ying Xia in the rally takes the first 2 points on serve.
So aggressive. Look how she springs into the backhand, how low she is. Strength in the legs, engaged with the core. So balanced.
This is the forehand that we saw yesterday against Chun Meng. Wang Manyu started off so fast and fluid.
Look at this here. Painting the table. She opens the body there to play the longer length. Cross table. Have to compact your stroke a little bit more if you want to play down the line.
Racket speed, some heavy topspin with that full stroke forehand.
Both have devastating forehands, but I'd say Sun's is a bit more direct and powerful. Wang Manyu is a taller player. Sometimes tries to feed off it a little bit because, of course, of her longer levers. Costs her more time to recover.
So far, the server has won every point. Percentage of the fans here for Sun Ying Xia. It's going to make it feel like an away game for Wang Manyu, which it is. Nice change, shallow just behind the net, completely changing the timing on this one.
Nice touch as well, guide flick. So hard to do that.
For me, that backhand, that spinny shot that came down just behind the net, as you said, mid-rally, it's almost counterintuitive. Qin Zhijian, Liu Guoliang watching on from the front row.
No pressure.
Yeah, no pressure. Now, these are arguably the two favorites to represent China in singles. You can only have two in the women's game and in the men's game for the singles event. The save was good, getting down to the ground. Wang Manyu, and the pattern is broken. I guess it was broken the point before, but look at this. Not much you can do there. Of course, hitting a roller would be awesome, but there's not so much room to go around the net there, under the net clamp. We've seen it all from down on the ground.
Yeah, I mean, these two would be the favorites, you feel. Sun Ying Xia, the shoo-in, the way she's played, being the world champion as well, the Grand Slam on the cards. But it's so tough to choose because even Chun Meng as well has over a 90% win rate against non-Chinese players.
And Wang Manyu?
I think as well.
Ooh, wow. Exciting to be here in these moments. The entrance today, the fans for these players. So many people here flew in. Someone flew in from Canada just for today.
Wow.
It'll help up the top of the net here. Shasha raises her hand in apology. Talk to us a little bit about the pressure. You said their record in the final compared to the other head-to-heads they have.
Yeah, Wang Manyu has a 3-1 head-to-head over Sun in finals. And the last time they played a final was here in Korea. ITTF ATTU Asian Championships final, and Wang won it in the fifth.
Beautiful shot here. What year was that final?
2023, last year.
Nice. Pretty fresh.
What a fade there from Sun. When she comes into that shot, misleads Wang Manyu.
It's the biggest separation we've seen yet in this match. There it is, the setup. It is so pretty. The way she accelerates and fully commits to this forehand on the step around.
Unbelievable here. And then instant. Timing of this shot here. The peak of the bounce. Identifying what Sun's possible options were after she just put a bit more vigor into the backhand, just a little bit wider. Great point construction and a flawless finish. She identified it was half long. That by no means is a long serve. If it is, better have the surprise factor.
Not easy to steal inside the table. Shasha doing well here. Second serve. On the move. This was an out of position shot. We talk about wingspan, but to be able to play that ball with your head down.
I don't know how she's done that. This loop from Sun was immense. And then, wow.
Moving target on the other side, nailed bullseye. Wang Manyu within two.
Shovel serve is so nice. It's a signature serve. Sun is more of a pendulum most of the time. But it just kind of stalls for a split second longer, and it gives Wang Manyu some extra time on a third ball. Sort of variation between topspin and backspin.
Service warning here. Toss, I'm going to guess. Back. There it is. Not vertically. Now, the rule says the toss must be nearly vertical. And if you ask, well, how does that work in numbers? How do you quantify that? No more than 30 degrees off of straight up in any direction. Left. Service.
7-8.
Pretty gutsy toss, considering.
Mm.
Not quite as severe as the one before, but still not changing her game too much. A little bit more height on this toss. And if you get used to a certain service toss, it can be quite jarring to have to change in moments like this where it's so tight.
It plays in your mind, doesn't it? And disrupts your rhythm in a way.
Mm.
But you've got to adhere to the regulations. Same for everybody.
Placement here behind the momentum, just the faintest move from Wang Manyu, and Shasha takes advantage.
Just thinking a little bit more outside the box with some of the shots we've seen, and she leaves Wang Manyu scratching ahead. Three game points.
Oh no, she did not! To recover that net ball as wide as could be. Looking to do what she does in finals. Win.
Last one.
Right now, the comfort level heavily favoring Sun Yingsha. The fact that she looked so comfortable against that net ball on many occasions was constantly mixing it up in game one. Saw little hesitation, the type of pressure that Wang Manyu normally puts on.
Please.
Makes it difficult to do what Sun Yingsha is doing.
Please.
Again, not Mardi Gras. No flashing. 2-0, Sun Yingsha. Now we're talking. This is the Wang Manyu that started the match and finished the match against Chen Meng yesterday.
She was better there, wasn't she, against the rhythm changes that Sun Yingsha was bringing into action with the backhand. It's kind of a guessing game. Was anyone going to switch down the line? Not that time.
And it happens here. Perfect escape. Wang Manyu takes her chances. With a long serve that fast and well placed, this isn't an easy shot.
Not at all. With backspin, but look at the precision. You cannot really put it into words how good that is.
Last
It could.
It will not. Good pressure there. We saw a few. Yesterday there was a great one.
We saw Sun do it, didn't we? Just a little drop shot back into the net.
Second bounce. Smile on the other side. But Wang Manyu in front here, keeping the pressure on. This is such a good point. I watch this and I think back to Hugo Calderano versus Fang Zhengzhong and how many times you can play a touch shot to keep someone off the attack.
Anyone who loves table tennis will take just as much joy out of that as watching a loop-to-loop line. Just denying each other the opening attack. So low, head so still, the awareness, the control.
It's a brave point.
And again.
City four.
That time they won't enter the hot potato.
Right, it's funny thinking about brave. When you think brave, you think of someone really taking a big risk. They are taking big risks by playing these touch shots against someone so powerful.
Yeah, because they're quite capable of playing a flick and then you can't get out quick enough.
Oh, just long on the counter, the power. This is the forehand that you were talking about.
Look at this here. She forces Wang Manyu back. Side spin. It's amazing she managed to lob that one down. Very hard to do it against a ball swerving and curving so much.
Right to the baseline. For Sha Sha to play that ball the way she did, a lot of players would have missed that point. There's no doubt that right now these are the two best players in the world.
Couldn't agree more. And we're not just saying that because of world ranking. It's the truth.
The quality of points. It's so fast. This is what we want to see. We want to see the best shot in the world and then having it come back even better. It just keeps building. Racket there, Sha Sha. You could hear the difference in sound as she spins that backhand on a parallel.
Yeah, it's a good indication of the spin, the sound. That's why you see some players stamp their foot when they serve. And also the logo, of course. The harder it is to see, usually the spinnier the ball.
Break off the net here for Sha Sha, and she's back up by three. It's how you finish the game.
It can be misleading. Seen so many comebacks here at this Champions.
So with the second towel break, I mentioned earlier, Wang Manyu, the best record I'd seen against Sun Ying Sha. Qian Tianyi with a slightly higher percentage, but about half the experience, meaning a smaller sample pool, so you could understand. Speaking of sample pools, in the last 8 points, Sun Ying Sha has taken the majority of the pool with 6 of 8, just leaving the jacuzzi there for Wang Manyu. The recovery from Sha Sha, and Wang Manyu is there for every single one.
Unbelievable shot tolerance. And you've barely got any time, so important to keep the bat high. Could you make a little comeback here, Wang Manyu? Best of 7 match, don't forget.
I couldn't believe she knew right away that this wasn't coming down. We're watching it wondering if it could have carried back. Sun Ying Sha keeping her eyes on it just in case.
The extension of Sun Ying Sha there. She exaggerates the movement. It was the parallel that got Wang Manyu out of position, and she's playing the lines a little bit more frequently and with more prowess at the moment, Sun.
Now 5 game points for the woman on top of the world, Wang Manyu, still a lot left to do. Slow spinny comes in, that causes trouble for most people. So far, 2-0. Sun Ying Sha doing the best she can.
And this right here is a reminder. Just don't forget, only last month at the World Champs, China were tested twice to the limit by India, and then, most pivotally, in the women's team final, Wang Manyu didn't even feature in that final.
It's quite a statement to how deep their roster runs. China rolls deep. Oh, the recovery. Sha Sha with a big recovery, and Wang Manyu right there for a bit of fortune. Quick inside the table, the racket speed that she can generate with this backhand is just incredible.
Flick here, she spotted straight away that it was topspin.
Right down the line after the net ball before, but still, it had to be a very precise, risky shot to get past.
Here she contorts her body here. Unbelievable.
You talk about still heads a lot, but Wang Manyu throws everything. It goes shoulder to shoulder on that one. It's the body working hard around that head.
Yes. 3-2. Comes through that last one just a little bit more. It's imperious, venomous from Sun Ying Sha.
Sun Ying Sha, the world number one, has won 12 of the last 16 points. For a player who's already 2-0 up, Wang Manyu is going to have to change that momentum. But easier said than done with the confidence and the power that Sun Ying Sha is playing with. She seems to be everywhere she needs to be.
It's the wisdom that she has for such a young player, how she reads, how she anticipates, how she can feel an opponent. Apologizes there for top edge of the racket, perhaps.
Down by two, Wang Manyu out of the first towel break. Oh, to the line. From the windows to the walls. No chance you can catch these balls as wide as they are in this rally.
Fans are getting every penny's worth here. It's brilliant to see the reaction to the ball kids as well.
Jaws dropped. And the edge, after all of that work, the variation of spin in this rally, Wang Manyu digging deep. As well as Wang Manyu's playing, it feels like no one else in the world could beat her right now.
Please.
Or would. But Sha Sha's up 6-2.
Oh, my God.
7-2.
Absolutely uncompromising. Picking her apart.
If you tried to swing as hard as you possibly could, she was still sort of fiddling around with the racket before she took that swing. And the racket speed she generated is tough to imagine, even if she was waiting for it for a speed gun.
Wang Manyu had barely even finished the aftermotion of a flick.
But a big swing here, and the recovery time, as you mentioned, a little bit more costly. Wang Manyu with the shield deflects.
Maybe Wang Manyu should try and distance herself a little bit further away from the table.
Ooh, that's a risky business. I don't know. We'll see. I guess I should ask you, why do you say that?
I think because the closer she is, the less time she has right now. I feel like it'll be a little bit more open, maybe, if the rally blossoms, if she can just give herself an extra yard away. I think it could help her.
probably be my last De Niro reference for the day, but there are two sides to that. There's a flip side to that coin.
There is.
She gets behind the table. That means more time for Sasha as well, and she knows what to do with time. Look at the serve, points won on serve here. Success rate, 70, nearly 71% for Sinying Sha. Wang Manyu, about 30 less. Just over 40% success. Unstoppable right now.
Wang Manyu knows what's going to happen if she posts it to forehand.
Just to pose another alternative solution to the idea of buying a little more time by being a step back. Short strokes. Easier said than done. 23 of the last 32 points. Sinying Sha. Sharing is caring, but right now, caring isn't her business. It's easier said than done in the sense that if you can stay close to the table. Oh, she caught the edge. That was faint. Take a look here one more time. Ooh, Shuang Yu, right off the double fish logo. Only has to touch even the slightest bit of the playing surface. 6 game points for a 3-0 lead. And Sha Sha looking at the fan vote, not liking it, taking control here. But the taller one's the one they want. So you and I were talking on break a little bit about some of the reasons that stepping back a little bit could be an advantage for Wang Manyu.
Yeah, I just feel like she can vary in more ways. There's only so many ways she can vary if she's closer. You would think it will give Sun more time and a more obvious angle to exploit, but I just feel it's going to take something a little bit more out of the ordinary of Wang Manyu's realm right now.
In terms of out of the ordinary, yesterday in the last 2 matches of the day with the Olympic champions, men and women, we saw them turn their racket backwards to confuse the opponent. And it worked better for Ma Long than it did for Chun Meng. First time I'd recalled seeing that. Interestingly enough, Liang Jingquan in the semifinals of the 2021 World Champs did the same thing against Fan Zhendong. No timeout called yet on either side. And if you're Wang Manyu, why not now? 0-3, the most common score, that 3-point differential. Be interesting if we did see Wang Manyu turn the racket around, but as we saw with Chun Meng and Ma Long for that matter, it takes time to adapt.
Yeah, it's a softer rubber. You usually see them twiddle to smash with it, but to do it in the middle of a rally shows they're trying to slow it down, perhaps add more spin.
Right, normally the Chinese national team against lobs, when they don't need that topspin, they'll put the softer springier rubber out.
6-love.
Not a point dropped yet, a flawless start for Sha Sha here.
I was getting ready for a potential 4-3. I mean, this is nuts. For her 10th WTT title, Sha Sha.
7-love.
I remember yesterday, Ma Long came back from down 0-7. Was able to win 13-11. I think Wang Manyu, the fact that she didn't call the timeout, she just figures it's gone. It's too late at this point. What do you do against this? So Liu Guoliang in the middle, Steve Dainton, CEO of ITTF Group, and Qin Zhijian, Secretary General for CTTA. Liu Guoliang, also on the executive board, higher up for WTT, as the president of CTTA as well.
I can't help but think, are we going to see an exhibition here if this continues like this?
Well, score, that's the first point for Wang Manyu, so for me that changes the chances of an exhibition. Oh, that was probably the longest leap and lunge I've ever seen from Sinying Sha moving into the table on an attack. Watch how far she comes for this.
bit of a chop block from Wang Manyu, wasn't it? And Sun thought, well, in this kind of form, this kind of score, try and go against the spin with all that body work.
I think a big part of the illusion also, as we saw in that second replay, was that the follow-up, the right leg came out after, so it really looked like she came a long way. She just realized she'd already missed the point, didn't need to recover. There will be no exhibition. This will be a fight till the end. I can't remember the last time I saw two Chinese women put on an exhibition point.
That's what I was thinking, but if it gets to 10, you wouldn't see it at 9, would you, or 8?
Normally not. I know you were calling a match the other day. I was sitting next to you when it seemed that Ellie Samara started an exhibition with 9. If you're newer to the sport, an exhibition point would basically be your way of saying, look, I have no chance. I can't figure out a plan. Let's make it good for the crowd. But here it will be a fight to the finish. Remember, Wang Manyu needing to show she's got that fighting spirit. Oh, how does it come back? Sasha omnipresent sets up 6 championship points. The world number one looking to collect some big points after being eliminated in Singapore just 2 weeks ago, fairly early. Championship point. And there it is, Sasha in fashion. A dominant performance like we have not seen in some time.